Hey, it's Kaylee, and in this lesson, we will learn to determine unbalanced and balanced forces on an object using free body diagrams. Remember that a force is a push or a pull on an object. And there are two different types of forces. Do you remember what they are? That's right, contact forces and non-contact forces. Some examples of contact forces are friction or applied forces like a push or a pull. And this means two objects are physically touching each other to apply the force. Examples of non-contact forces are gravity and magnets. This means two objects are still interacting, but they're at a distance from each other and they don't need to be physically touching to apply force. Can you recall what happens when an object is experiencing an unbalanced force? That's right, it moves. In fact, as long as the unbalanced force is acting on it, it will accelerate. And remember that to accelerate means that it will change speed or direction or both. We can simplify this by saying an object that is accelerating is changing its velocity. And do you recall the difference between speed and velocity? It's direction. Since velocity describes an object's speed and direction, we call it a vector quantity. A vector quantity is something that has magnitude, like the amount of or how much of something there is, and the direction. If something only has a magnitude, we call it a scalar quantity. Some examples of vectors are things like force, which has a magnitude, the number of newtons, and a direction, like up or down or left or right. And acceleration and velocity are vectors that have a speed, the magnitude, and a direction, or a change in either one of those things. Some examples of scalars are things like speed, which is the number of meters per second an object is moving, but no direction is associated to it. Or mass, which is the magnitude of kilograms an object has, but obviously no direction. Sometimes it can be hard to tell if an object is experiencing balanced or unbalanced forces. We use a tool called the free body diagram to help us determine if an object will experience an unbalanced force. Why do you think that this would be important? Architects and builders use free body diagrams when building houses and apartments. It's important for them to know if the walls or the roof will experience any unbalanced forces, because that would mean the house would accelerate, and that would be really dangerous. That would mean the walls or the roof could fall down. And civil engineers and bridge designers also use free body diagrams to make sure bridges are experiencing balanced forces only, even with lots of traffic and wind. They've designed different types of bridges to withstand different forces so they never accelerate. When we draw free body diagrams, we represent the object as a box. Even if the object is a dog or a person, we still draw them as a box. And we use arrows to represent force. The arrow points in the direction the force is acting. And we use big arrows to represent bigger forces and smaller arrows to represent smaller forces. Do you want to do an example? Draw a free body diagram for a 20 kilogram ball at rest on the ground. So the first thing we can do is draw our object. They told us a 20 kilogram ball, but since we draw all of our objects as a box, we can just go like this. Now let's determine what forces are acting on the ball. They told us the ball is at rest, so that means no acceleration, and that would mean the forces are balanced. And we know the ball has mass, so we can assume gravity is acting on the ball. And gravity points down, so we can draw the down arrow just like this. And the example says the ball is at rest, not accelerating through the ground. So we need to draw the normal force arrow pointing straight up, just like this. Lastly, we label the arrows so we can easily determine what forces are balanced and what forces are unbalanced. So here we labeled the bottom arrow FG for the gravity force and the top arrow FN for the normal force. So nice work! You just drew your very first free body diagram. But let's try a more complex example now. Draw a free body diagram for a 20 kilogram lawnmower being pushed across a field. The lawnmower is accelerating across the field by 2 meters per second squared from the push. So the first thing we can do is draw our object, and we'll just use a box to represent the lawnmower, so it'll be like this. And now let's think about our forces. We know the lawnmower has mass, so we can assume gravity is acting on it, so we can draw our gravity arrow like this. And the question says the mower is accelerating across the field, but not through the ground. So we can draw the normal force arrow acting up and balancing with the gravity arrow. So it'll be like this. Finally, we come to the force that is causing the acceleration. A push is causing the mower to accelerate 2 meters per second squared to the right. So we draw the arrow to the right of the box and show what direction the force is acting. Now we need to make sure that there is an unbalanced force in the direction of the mower. And right now it looks like there is. The F push is to the right, and there is no arrow pointing to the left to balance it out. But what can we assume about the field of grass? I think we can assume that there's friction. And the friction force opposes motion, so it makes it harder to move. So we can draw the friction force arrow in the opposite direction of the pushing force. But should the friction force be bigger, smaller, or equal to the pushing force? It should be smaller. We need the unbalanced forces to point in the direction of acceleration, which is to the right, the direction the pushing force is pointing. So great job! You just drew a free body diagram for an object with balanced force and for an accelerating object. Keep practicing with the practice problems and remember to always be clever! Hey, hey.